even until the colonial era, the British came, the Portuguese came, the Dutch came, the Malays still embraced Islam and Islam. You know, the Christianity that being bring by the colonial people. So what makes the Malays accept Islam so easily?
Well, a great many factors can be ushered or can be mastered to answer that question. Why was it so easy for the Malays to accept Islam? Well, perhaps it wasn't that easy because we know that based on the records, at least in the first chapter which we discussed last month, some of the earliest missionaries had been dispatched since the time of Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan. We need to say that was very early. And during the time of the Sharif of Mecca, they established the gradual small kingdoms, of course, in the northern Sumatra. And then eventually they got the kingdom of Pasai. Afterwards, of course, the first real model of the great empire of the Malays, I would argue, is Malacca. One of the principles they say was that the people annas ala dini mulukihim, that the people will follow the religion of their kings. And their kings were the ones, I mean, the people who were sent to Islamize this part of the world were missionaries, meaning to say they were people who had a mission, they were people who were professionals, shall we say. They had a strategic plan in that sense. Of course, we don't have the blueprints, but we can trace it from the effects of their works. Because the extent of the Islamization was so profound, so intense, because it involves first the electing of one language among the multiple languages that exists. And that suggests that it was not a panicky move, nor an accidental move, for you to choose a language and then to develop it until it became modern Malay as we know it. That language, as it developed, if you look at the intellectual contents of the Malay language, even the intellectual terms as we use it today, we'll have traces of the theological discussions of Sunni kalam until today. Yes? And why is that? Because they used the language and they translated major texts in aqidah, in fiqh, in tasawwuf. So one, because the focus was on the internal rather than the external. The Islamization was not just on the body, but the Islamization was through language. And language influences the mind, and the mind influences the heart. One. Secondly, it produced a civilization. Multiple kingdoms were produced in this part of the world that were Muslim. And furthermore, as we said about the identity of the missionaries, they were people who came directly from the household of the Prophet. And they were people of great personalities. These were people whose life was spent in the propagation of the religion of Islam. As a result, the Malays absorbed this within their character. And then furthermore, it provided them a new sense of identity. Whereas previously they had been multiple peoples divided by culture and language, they became one. Meaning to say they were given a new identity, united by the Malay language and the religion of Islam and the customs that is shaped based on the religion of Islam. It came with civilization, it came with astronomy, it came with the sciences, it came with as we said, when you look at the Malacca Kingdom, it came with the Hukum Kanun, Hukum Laut, and multiple ways of kingdom. So basically from the smallest to the biggest, it came with advanced literature also. You see the Hikayats in the 15th century, Muhammad Hanafi and several of the other Hikayat that were written. So basically, it is a very culturally rich Islamization. Because it's very difficult for us to imagine these things, since the civilization was built using wood, so it doesn't last for hundreds of years. But the invisible parts, meaning to say the linguistic part, remains in the manuscripts. So that's another factor. So and then furthermore, the scholars who came here, they did not come with military presence. Nobody was forced to convert. And since there was no forced conversion, the acceptance of the religion became something which was, shall we say, without compulsion. And that became the identity of the Malays. And of course, after that, it became consolidated and consolidated every generation with the renewal of the scholars from amongst the locals, as well as renewed interest by the ruling class. There was a very good relationship between the sultans and the ulama. We know this from the Hikayat Raja Pasai, from Sulalatus Salatin or Sejarah Melayu, as well as Hikayat Aceh, that the house or the palace of the sultans had always been the place of religious debates of metaphysical nature and so on. So our identity was formed by the religion in that sense.